Dr. Juanita Bynum, singer, author, motivational speaker, and minister. A well-respected leader and businesswoman in the Christian community for many years. A few weeks ago, she was quite popular on social media after it became popular news that she's hosting a $1,500 per person 4-week intensive prayer institute. The event is marketed as an intensive learning program designed to teach her personal techniques for effective prayer. The event is heavily marketed as an inspiration and mission from God, which is causing even more backlash from both Christian and non-Christian critics. What is it that's fueling the contempt of her critics? Is her institute worth the price? Let's tackle these questions and more when we chat about Juanita Bynum. As a disclaimer, I'll say that issues of religion and how those in the industry may or may not profit from it are very touchy, no matter how you approach them, but thankfully, this is not what this video is about. Plenty of other YouTubers are covering this topic from that point of view, including the potential moral or ethical implications. I'm simply approaching this from a business perspective. I'm not a supporter of her, but neither do I have any negative viewpoints concerning her character. With that said, this business analysis of her institute is just my personal opinion. Before we get into the good, the bad, and takeaways, I want to highlight a few key parts of her actual promotional video that's found on her YouTube channel, Dr. Juanita Bynum. Let's listen and break it down.
This is what I do, but I believe the Lord is calling us in this hour to not be able to say this is what I do, but this is who I am. And all of the years that I have been in ministry, the Lord, he just kept taking me back to the foundation of prayer and telling me that no matter where I go and what I do, if I'm going to be successful at anything, it's going to be birthed out in prayer. And I want you to understand something that when you...
So what we just heard was the introduction. She's telling us about the Institute and the inspiration behind it.
During your weakest hours. And I believe that we are at that place now where the Lord is compelling me that it's time to teach next level prayer. That's right. If you're an intercessor that is watching, you are a prophet that is watching, you are a pastor that is watching, the Lord opened up to me the libraries of heaven as it relates to prayer. And this isn't something that I feel that I need to stand and try to convince you of. Nobody, and I mean nobody, walked through what I have walked through in the last 15 years. Back in 2007 and losing everything, even almost my mind, and you come out looking like what you have been through. That has to be a person that understands that there's a secret to this thing called prayer.
Here she identifies her target demographic and also shares a bit of personal testimony.
And the Institute is now open and it begins October the 6th in Atlanta, Georgia. And I want to tell you what we will be doing in this institute. This is not something that I'm going to invite thousands of people to be a part of, because I want to be able to be the instructor that God has called me to be. And that is a prophetic instructor that I am sure that while I am teaching to you, you are getting a real impartation. I have to be able to look down in your spirit and see if you are fanning out or are you receiving the tools that you're going to need for this next turn in our society. And trust me when I tell you.
All right, so the part we just heard, she's giving us the when, the where, the what of this institute.
The libraries of heaven. And I'm here to tell you now that we cannot just keep gathering people together and saying, let's pray, without having those that are skilled in prayer, those that know how to operate in next level prayer, or watch this. What we're doing is we're swinging around in a lot of emotions and we're not getting any results because there is a strategic method to not just tapping heaven, not just causing the portal to open, but allowing you to live in it and walk in it. And I know what I'm talking about because that is exactly what I have been experiencing in my life. There is no way that I should be doing what I am doing. There is no way that the testimonies that sit on my life right now, even some that you all really don't know about yet, there is no way that it should be happening. But prayer doesn't just change things when you know how to pray. And when you know the strategies of the next level praying. Yeah.
So now we know exactly what the intent or purpose of this institute is.
So in this particular institute, it's going to be 4 weeks of intensive 2-hour teaching. On the 4th week, I'm going to be ministering for 3 days. This is some of the things you're going to get. Those 2 hours, we're going to allow you to have Q&A where you can ask questions so that you can make sure that you have a full understanding of the next level teaching that I'm getting ready to do. The Prayer Institute, something that I'm very excited about. You will receive a certificate signed by me with the seal of my Prayer Institute stating that you have properly been trained to be an intercessor and you know exactly what you are doing. And at the end of that 4th week, I am going to be mantling you with a full-length prayer shawl that I am consecrating over, not just a half prayer shawl, but these prayer shawls are for people that have gone through this course, and I'm going to personally lay hands on you and cover your head with the prayer shawl. By that time, I would have taught it intensely, things that I have not released yet, that is in upcoming books that God has prepared. And I'm telling you, your life will never be the same.
All right, so here's the meat of the video where we really dive into what is the content that's going to be available to those who attend.
And so I'm inviting you to register right now. I only have 150 seats. Because I want to make this intensive. You can go to www.juanitabynum.com. I want to make this intensive to the point that when you come out, you know that you are properly equipped. So this is your seat. I want to invite you to take a seat. I want to invite you to come to the next level of prayer. I want to invite you to get out of the clutches of the enemy. To get out of the reach of satanic chaos in conversation and come to a realm where you speak those things which be not as though they were, where you can decree a thing and you are more than positive that God is going to bring it to pass. Registration is open right now. And when I get to the 150 people, I will have to close it.
The last bit was about the limited seating. And this video and her website are the only information that I'm using to make this video. There's lots of other articles, but I just kind of wanted it to be just what I saw. So these are the sources that I'll be using concerning the Prayer Institute in my analysis. So I'll start with the part that has everyone really upset, the price. From a business perspective, the price sets the level of exclusivity. This event is not meant to be a meet and greet event for lay people in the church or just admirers. Higher prices are a common practice in business to limit event or seminar attendees to serious inquiries only. The target demographic is spiritual leaders, intercessors, pastors, and those who feel they have a gift for prayer but want to deepen their knowledge and understanding. She gives the analogy that the institute is like a school, and a payment plan is available for those that desire to stretch out payments, which makes it more accessible. One part I thought was a little weird was when she said the company affirm gave them permission to offer a payment plan, and you can see that in this clip I'll insert right here.
And I want to remind you of something that God did for us here at Juanita Bynum International for this prayer institute. A firm gave us permission to offer this registration to the people that register, where they can pay by way of a firm, which means you pay a down payment and you pay for it like you're going to school, like you're going to college, and you're paying for your education. So you don't have to say, well, Dr. Bynum, I don't have all of it right now. It's made available to you, and you need to go to the website right now. Like I said, it begins.
So I don't think they were given exclusive rights, since even I have installment payments enabled on my website. I just thought that part was a little strange. The event is limited to 150 people, which again adds to that level of exclusivity to encourage people to act now. The same way websites will engage countdown timers and almost gone banners. But it also keeps the number low enough for a more intimate feel without attendees being lost in a sea of other people. To be in such a small group, you are more likely to have direct access to the speaker and have your questions answered. Juanita Bynum has a name that sells itself, backed by a long history in inspirational and ministerial work. So institute goers will have direct access to her knowledge and expertise that she has acquired after decades of ministry. So she's marketing and selling access to her techniques and personal processes. Attendees also have access to brand new content. Bynum highlighted in the previous clips that she's releasing new content before it's even published in upcoming books that she's planning. So she's not simply marketing the same content people already have access to, but engaging them face to face with new content. The majority of her detractors seem to take issue mostly with the fact that Bynum is quote unquote monetizing prayer and the Bible. Critics argue the Bible was written for free and Christ taught people the Lord's Prayer for free. So how could you make money off of it? I feel the backlash is more an attack on her character than her business practices. This seminar is 7 2-hour classes over the course of an entire month, totaling 14 hours, which may be fine for virtual or local participants, but this may not be feasible for people who live long distances and don't have the finances to commute the distance weekly. I really think a week-long event would be more intensive, but I don't really know what events or assignments are taking place in between each meeting, which leads to the next point. Simply looking at the website product listing, you cannot really see the value of the institute being worth the cost. Language is important. Using the right language can make or break an offer. Being clear and precise. It's a bold move for any business to ask people to click buy simply on faith. I think the listing on her website could really use a lot more information to really justify for both potential attendees and critics alike the high price for this event. The page where people are clicking buy needs to be engaging, so people aren't just paying their hard-earned money and hoping for the best. She's missing a valuable opportunity to give people a behind-the-scenes view of what the event could be like. Even adding testimonials from previous seminars, having participants give heartfelt testimonies of how much value the experience or her teachings added to their life would help to assuage the harsh criticism that her prayer institute is now receiving. This may be the area where the ball was dropped. I'm sure Bynum is not running her own website, but her team definitely needs to update the site. When researching, I went straight to the website and decided I'm not going to scour the internet just to learn more. That's the website's job. It seems to be assuming that I viewed other information in another place and am just visiting the site to submit my payment. Maybe after the payment, you will receive an email with more details, but even the description should say that. When incorporating some of these tactics into our own business practices, when charging a large amount for a product or service, you should first understand your target demographic and if this is something they would even be interested in. Second, make sure the product or service that you're providing is enough value for the price. I've paid $2,000 for an intensive class. I think I'm still paying for it 2 years later, but it spanned months of small group work, weekly live check-ins and Q&As with a coach, self-paced online lessons, homework, one-on-one help when needed, access to a private Facebook support group, and continued support even after my time in the program was over, all with a well-respected industry professional. You have to make sure your offer is worth the cost to customers. If Juanita Bynum's Prayer Institute provides everything promised and those who paid the fees are happy with what they received, then there really isn't any downside. Charge your value. Your reputation, time, knowledge, and skill set all have a value. She has been in her profession for decades. When you're considered an expert in your field, there tends to be a price to pay for access. Customers should be excited and confident when they click the Buy Now button on your website. Give whatever you're offering a detailed description and even some images and testimonials so customers have no question as to what they will receive for their purchase. Payment plans are a great addition to any website selling goods to consumers. The option to space out payments for more expensive orders gives your customers the option to buy more at one time. On my site, up to 11% of sales per month is paid using an installment payment program. Never make a customer do a scavenger hunt to find details of your product. A well-written description for your product's purchase page, complete with images, should leave customers with no questions and the desire to confirm the purchase. Thanks for listening. Go ahead and hit the like and subscribe button to help out the channel. Considering that Dr. Bynum more than likely has a professional team helping her run her business, I definitely expected a lot more from her website and marketing surrounding this event. What are your thoughts about the points I brought up in this video? If you have something to add to the conversation, leave a comment below. This is Andrea Marah. Peace and blessings.